Hello guys, welcome back to Yakuza Games. I went game hunting again, and I came up with a whole lot of stuff this time, but this was an all-in-one trip. I've been doing these videos for a while, so this is pretty much it all together. First thing I wanted to show you guys is actually pretty cool. I went to some place like deep in the city, and they had these NES titles here, and what was weird about it was they had them all packaged in fours, like in a plastic bag, and they're selling each bag for $4. I do believe there was four bags, and one of them actually had five titles in there as opposed to four, but I think they just wanted to bunch it all together instead of selling it by itself. But yeah, I'll run you through these titles we got here. It was like $4 a bag, four titles, so $1 each, pretty much. And I tested them all out. The only game I think that did not work was this guy here, SNK's, what was that, Lee Trevino's Fighting Golf. But I could live with that. Okay, so let's go down the list, starting on the left side here. If you notice, you got two copies of Super Mario 2. What was weird is they actually put both of them in one bag, which I thought was kind of weird. I would have thought they would have, you know, separated them. Kung Fu, I do believe that was ARM that made that game, and might have been ported over here by Nintendo. I honestly don't remember the history behind that. Taito's, let me just bring them around here. Taito's Bubble Bobble. This was a port of an arcade game, and it's fairly popular during its time. And a packing game here, that would be Mario and Duck Hunt. I actually saw the zapper, the red zapper, at a place for $4, but decided not to pick it up. Okay, this would be the second list here. This is another arcade game. I do believe you can find this on Capcom Collections for the PS2 and Xbox, but this is Trojan by Capcom. RoboCop, based on the movie, of course, Data East. The Nintendo version of Tetris, which is actually still one of my favorites to play. That one's good. Well, you can tell by the young Hulk Hogan that this is WrestleMania. Gosh, yeah, I don't know how the heck I played that game back in the day. I had a blast with it, though. This one was actually pretty fun, too. Ice Hockey. Another Capcom title. Mickey Mousecapade. When this one was released here in the States, they actually did change a lot of the characters, like, as far as enemies were concerned. And I do believe you fired stars on this one instead of some sort of wafer that looked like it came off of Pac-Man for the 2600. Okay, and we got this last list here. Fighting Golf, of course, this one did not work. It would go to the title screen and then just go white. Batman the Video Game. If you like games like Ninja Gaiden or Vice, if you ever played Vice, this pretty much goes into the same category. It's actually a really good game by Sunsoft. One of the better Batman games for the 8-bit systems. Okay, this is Alan Sir Jr.'s Turbo Racing by Data East. Of course, this one here, yeah, I used to make fun of a lot when I was when it came out because of commercials and what, but this is actually a pretty fun game, to be honest. I didn't try it out until I got it here. Top Gun Second Mission. If you like the first one, this one here is a pretty good improvement. Let's see here. Tecmo Star Force. This is also based off of an arcade game by Tecmo. I do believe you could get this on one of their game collections. I think I have it. Yeah, Tecmo Arcade. Classic Arcade. I have it actually for the Xbox there. It's the second blue one to the right. Yeah, the actual arcade game is on there. This was actually the first game we got for the Famicom. It came with, we got to choose a game with the system we bought, and this was the one that we chose. came in an orange case. It was actually pretty cool. And one of my favorite games from back in the day, Double Dragon 2, just because they finally added the two-player co-op on there, which I was really disappointed when. I saw the 8-bit version of Double Dragon, and I was so accustomed to the arcade, and seeing it on the Play 10 arcade also, I was like, man, yeah, it was a compromise, but this one wasn't that bad. Okay, next up we have here, these guys are $2 each. My sister actually liked this game back in the day. This would be Sim City. If you're not familiar with that game, basically you build cities and try to finance them as well. Try to make them as efficient as possible. Surprisingly, this was $2. Bomberman 2, I'm a huge Bomberman fan. Yeah, I've never had the second game. I have, I think, part 4 for the Super Famicom. But yeah, not a bad find. And here, well, this had its time and day. This here would be, I bought them individually. I found them in different places, but the actual Konami's Dance Revolution mats, I got two of them, of course, and then I found this one here for $2. If you remember my other videos where they would always sell one disc, if it had one disc in it, for $2, that's where I got this one. Yeah, not a huge fan. I think it kind of went south when it came out domestically. You know, the hardcore fans kind of took over the show on that one. Oh, this would be that other one that I did. If you remember the first one I did, when I compared the two side by side, I decided to do this one here. You can tell it's a different, the other one, because the port is on the side as opposed to the back. And I did remove that fourth input there, or actually output. Yeah, just to make it look a little bit more cleaner. Yeah, that's just probably the last project I did as of recent. Now these guys here. These were also $2. I got them from the same place I got the Dance Dance Revolution. And again, if you had one or two discs, it was $2 for the set, and then each additional disc was $2. And let me start out with this one here. As you guys know, I'm a Neo Geo fan, so I did pick this one up. I did have a copy of this already, but you know, for $2, I was like, yeah, might as well. The only thing I didn't care for was the music actually stopped in between characters, and they fixed that when they brought out the one after that. This one here was actually a really popular game. There was a lot of hype behind this one. This is the first Shenmue, and it is complete. It comes with a booklet and whatnot. They charged me $6, I do believe, for this. No. Yeah, $6, and I'll tell you why. It's because it had an extra disc that came with the Phantasy Star, I do believe, which was a demo disc, but they plopped it in here, so they charged me for what they should have charged me on this one for this one here. Okay, that's Shenmue. I still haven't beat that game. We're getting cracking on it. I already have the second one. Okay, and this would be Phantasy Star Online. Now, if you notice, the disc this I was telling you guys about is actually inside this one here. Let's see if I can flip it across without doing anything to it. But yeah, it was a demo disc of Sonic Adventure 2. They charged me for that, but you know, whatever. Yeah, this one here had the two-disc jewel case. And what is weird is that this one here actually has two of the game on there. I do believe the demo disc was supposed to be a second game, if I'm not mistaken. And, yeah. So I got two copies of Phantasy Star Online for $2, so $1 each. Which, yeah, I didn't notice until I checked the one I actually had, and it was only one disc. I thought it was a double disc set when I purchased it. Okay, and last but not least, I got two Dreamcasts here. This one was just the bare unit, And then the other one had the controller and everything. This one here went for $40, and it wasn't that bad of a deal. It's kind of weird because when I took a look at this one, they were actually selling this one separately for $10 and this $40 with the cords and everything. And I was like, isn't that a set? So they gave it to me for $40. I don't know why there was another tag on there, but that's the way it should have been. And then this one was selling for $20. And this one here was not in a glass case or anything like this one was. And I picked this one up first. And I already planned it, but what I had done was I got this one and brought it up, and then I asked to take a look at this one. And after we talked about the controller and all that, they told me that this all, you know, it's all together, it's not separately. They were asking me if I still wanted this one, and I was like asking, I was wondering, hey, can you give me a better deal if I bought both of them? And instead of giving me this one for $20, they gave it to me for $10, so I decided to pick it up. From my experience, I haven't seen any of these, like, really mess up on people, so I went ahead and picked them both up and got it for $10. So if you think about it, $50 for the two, and then, you know, divided by two, it's about $25 a piece. That's the way I rationalized, you know, the two items. But yeah, both of them do work. And if you notice here, this guy here, I mean, there's really nothing much wrong with it. I mean, it looks pretty much, other than having a little bit of dust on it, I haven't cleaned it yet, but yeah, the logos and everything, you know, there's no scratches or what, and the controller seems fine as well. And I did test them both, and yeah, they work fine. Yeah, so just in case, you know, you had some time to burn, that's basically what I found, I guess, over a week and a half there. And of course, you know, the modded system, nothing too spectacular, like I said. But yeah, I thought the NES stuff was the greater find. But yeah, thanks again for watching, guys. This is Yakuza Games, and I'll have another video up here soon.